Okay, so here's going to be the third and final part of my MyFord Touch demo. If there's anything that I didn't cover at all in any of the three parts that you'd like to see covered, just leave me a comment and I'll do my best to get back to you, either make a video or explain a feature or something. So last time I didn't have anything hooked up to the USB port, and I have my third generation iPod Touch in there. So now I'm going to show you how your iPod is controlled to the sync system. It's going to be right through here. This is your USB. Select that. This is what your general iPod interface is going to look like. Feel free to make fun of my music. I don't really care. You get your album art over here. This is going to be your song title, of course, and the artist, play, skip. You can repeat, shuffle, similar music. Your options, as far as the iPod is concerned, is the same, pretty much. I mean, your sound settings, you can change your text display for different formats right here. And then go into your media player settings and all the other kind of stuff. This is, you see, yeah, this is your setup for autoplay and your Bluetooth devices here. So that's kind of how that works. Quick audio demo. Before I get flagged by Viacom or somebody, we'll stop that. That's what the iPod interface looks like. And if you press browse here, you can browse all through your iPod. It's just like an iPod. It's the same way. Your music. And again, you can do playlist, artist, albums, all that other kind of stuff. Genre composure. And that's how you navigate through your iPod. And you can use voice commands once it indexes your device. It takes a little while to index your device, but let's do, I'm going to start playing it again. To do it quietly, I'll do one quick demo of the voice commands. Pull the paddle.
Please say a command.
Play artist Stevie Nicks.
Playing artist Stevie Nicks.
And you can do it by song. And again, there's a whole list of voice commands. You can go into the settings menu and look at all your audio voice commands if you want to go further in depth with that. But you can say play genre, play song, play artist, and everything once the devices have been all indexed and everything. So the vehicle's familiar with, you know, all the different, artists and, like I said, genres and songs that it's able to play. So now let me go into the phone part here. I'm going to do a separate video showing you how to pair a Bluetooth device, but this video is going to be just assuming you've already paired the device, because that takes a little bit of time to go through and explain. But basically, really quickly, what you would do is go into your settings of your phone, Bluetooth devices, and these are my two Bluetooth devices, my favorite, which is the phone, and my iPod. You basically say add device. And sync ends up giving you a PIN number. It's a 6-digit PIN number. You turn your Bluetooth on your phone or whatever and look and type in the PIN number, and then it connects you up to sync. It's really simple and easy to do. But like I said, this is just if the device is already paired. So this is what it looks like. Let me see. If you go back to the home screen, you see what I was talking about earlier. You got redial, quick dial, your phone book. A little bit of functions here in the fourth screen one. And here's your keypad here, dial. Again, this is all voice activated. I can pull the paddle, the voice paddle right here. You can't really see my hand, but you pull this paddle and we can say, you know, call whoever, and then it'll call them. And again, like I said, all the voice functions are going to be available to you. You can look up in the menu, or they're also in the owner's manual, but they take a lot of time to go through, so I'm not going to right now. This is quick dial. This is your speed dialing right here. You can customize a whole bunch of those. This is your phone book right here. These are all the contacts on my phone, alphabetical order, your call history right here, I guess it doesn't matter if you see the numbers, Let me see. Long story about Steph also being called Sue Wong. I won't bother getting into that one, but it's rather entertaining. This thing will read text messages aloud. It doesn't censor swear words, so I think one of these doesn't have a swear word in them. My friends and I have been experimenting quite a bit with it. So, I'll just play this one. I know this one doesn't have any swear words in it. It's calling my friend a retarded elephant, so I didn't know if you wanted to hear the sink lady say that because it's funny.
Jeb is a big retarded elephant.
So yeah, it will say anything. It doesn't stop swearing. It'll say anything. So it's very amusing if you have friends with that kind of sense of humor, because they can text you in your car. It'll say anything. So that's really fun to play with. You can send a text message with this car. And basically, I think you have to select from a pre-selected choice here. Let me see. I'm going to go back to messaging. Or let me see. Let me try to reply to somebody. Just do Steph again. So if you do... Oh, I don't want to press listen because that one's probably inappropriate. Everything from Steph is always inappropriate. But anyway.
Jeb is a big retarded elephant.
So anyway, what I can do is hit reply here. And then, see, this gives me my pre-selected ones. And I think you can customize these, too. But these are just the stock ones in the car. But anyway, that gives you that. So that's a quick overview of what your phone setup looks like. And, like I said, I'll show you how to pair a phone in another video. But it's pretty straightforward. And finally, I want to end with showing you sync services. This gives you, you can get traffic reports, turn-by-turn directions. There's also personalized information and stuff that you can download from Sync applications, which are right here. And then you can, you know, install your applications and stuff. But just a quick, and the way Sync services work, it's not quite like OnStar. It uses your Bluetooth-enabled phone to call Sync services, which is fully automated. It's free for 3 years, and I think it's $90 a year after the 3 years of it being free. So it's free for the whole lease on this vehicle, so that's kind of cool. So I'm going to say connect to services.
Connecting. Services. Which service do you want?
Directions.
Directions. First, say the city and state you're going to, or say home or work.
Go back.
Services. Which service do you want?
And that's kind of how that works, and she'll go and talk you through, and then you just say the, like if you're doing directions like I like to do. I haven't actually heard the voice guidance yet. I just wanted to see how easy she could understand my directions, and she got my home address perfectly right the first time, so, and that gives you voice prompts and everything. So, yeah, I think that's going to conclude my full comprehensive tour of my Ford Touch, as I've said. Quite a few times now, I think. If there's anything I didn't do or you want to see, aside from pairing devices, which I'll make in a separate video, just leave me a comment and I'll get back to you on that. And thanks for watching.